What's up, everybody? It's your boy Deez, aka the PvP God, and welcome to the first episode of Sakura, the most useless talk show about anime and gaming. All right, guys, without further ado, I'd like to present my first ever guest on Sakura, Nogetsuna. Nogetsuna, what's up, baby? How you doing today?
Yo, what's up, Deez? It's your boy Nogetsuna, and I'm okay. Chilling. You know, it's a nice way to spend my day off is on this damn podcast, Sakura podcast, yeah. The most useless podcast alive.
Most useless podcast. We don't even need it. That's how useless it is, but we're going to...
That's what
we call it. It's a good name, don't you think?
I guess, yeah.
You like it.
I was thinking, like, Sakura would be like, oh, wow, like, you know, the like, cherry blossoms type thing.
Not it. Fuck. All right, so question: what anime are you watching right now?
What anime am I watching?
Yeah.
Shit. So, right now, I finished Demon Slayer like a few weeks back. I started reading the manga, but I finished it, but like started reading the manga, like I said.
Yeah, the last chapter is supposed to come out like today, right?
I think it already came out. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm kind of happy about that. I don't read the manga, but
Well, I'm glad it's ending. Maybe all the fanboys will stop praising it as a second coming of fucking Jesus Christ.
It's a good anime.
It's good, but it's not anime of the year worthy.
I don't believe that.
I
think it was, as far as last year, I think it was like a top tier anime along with, I personally love The Promised Neverland. It was amazing. There was a lot of bangers last year too. Astral Lost in Space was another one, but it was like a one season thing. It was a complete story. But yeah, so they're finished Demon Slayer. That means there should be no fillers. Mm-hmm. with the next coming seasons. What do you think about My Hero Academia? A lot of people call that as like the second coming and shit like that.
Well, it's good. I haven't caught up with the latest season, but I've watched it all up to like the whole where they introduced the big three students or whatever.
Yeah.
But I liked it. Like I said, it's good. It is probably one of the next big three, but I still, I don't know. Like I really enjoy watching it, but at the same time, it's like one of those things where it doesn't like pique my interest to want to keep watching and keep watching and keep watching. I don't know why. Like, I like it, but I just feel like I've seen that generic shonen thing so many times to the point where I'm not too intrigued by it. Mm. But, like, it doesn't catch my interest for whatever reason.
Yeah.
But I really like the characters in there. I just don't. I don't like Deku as a main character. I don't
know. Why not, dude?
He's so pathetic, and I don't know why. I like him, bro. It feels, like, so generic. But I don't know. I find myself liking like Todoroki and Bakugo.
Bakugo. It took me a little bit to like him. I didn't start liking him till after the second fight with Deku, and then you realize like why he is the way he is and shit.
Oh yeah. That definitely went around the time I started liking him more, because I thought he was just an asshole before that.
Yeah.
But Todoroki's one of my favorite characters in that whole show.
Todoroki's dope.
And then Bakugo grew on me too, and I'm like, yeah. And I'm just like, well, Deku's just fucking Deku. I don't know. And the way he started, something I don't like is I guess it's cool, but it's kind of just let me explain this like this. So every time he talks, like, you know, before a show starts or before something happens, he's like, this is my story, how I became the number one hero. It's like, I don't like that they have to say, hey, you know, I became the number one hero. I guess it's to show what he went through, but I would like it better if it was showing like what he's going through at the moment, so it doesn't feel like we know he's gonna make it to the end. Like,
you don't want that constant reminder.
I don't want to know that he became Hokage, you know, like I want to see him get there, but I don't want to know, like, if I want to know if, like, is he gonna get there, is he gonna lose friends along the way? He probably will, you know. But,
like Naruto would have been different if, like, in the beginning he would have said, this is my story of how I became Hokage, believe it. And
exactly. That's something I don't like about my heroes. Like, damn it, why you gotta tell me? Imagine One Piece, like, this is how I became Pirate King. Like, I don't want to know if he became Pirate King. Like, let me find out. Which, by the way, if we go back to your previous question, I have been watching One Piece as well, which is really, really fun so far.
Yeah, I've been watching what?
One Piece.
A lot of people have been trying to get me to watch One Piece. It's too long, but that's no excuse because I watched Naruto. But
I gotta say, you watched Naruto.
I know. That's everybody's counter argument. I do want to watch One Piece. I am gonna eventually sit down and watch One Piece. I just gotta finish up a couple things. Like I still got like 3 episodes left of Cells at Work that I put off for like a year, and Wifey's been on my ass about watching Shield Hero and Reincarnated as a Slime. I haven't watched them yet. I'm stuck on Bleach. Bleach to me is like your My Hero. Like I like it. I like the characters. I just nothing makes me sit down and want to like binge it. So like I watch like 2 episodes like a week and shit and just move on. And I watch other stuff.
Okay, so you're just like slowly going through it.
Yeah, I'll get through it eventually, but just not at a normal pace. Like, I'd rather watch like I'm watching Glepnor right now, which is it's like a D game anime. Guy turns into like this big ass teddy bear, and this is very fan servicey.
What? Okay.
Yeah. And the girl goes inside of him to control him, but like she has to go inside of him like half naked and shit. It's very fan servicey. What
I will say? Shield Hero is actually really good. For the slime, I started it and it's really good, but I have not gone back to watching it. Because the thing with me is I like to take breaks. Like when, like with One Piece, like currently I'm at a part where I'm like, okay, I can stop here. There's no cliffhangers or nothing. Like if I stop watching here, I'm not going to be like, oh damn, what happened next time? Like I like to take breaks with my anime at a good point to where it's not like there's nothing being left to be, you know, dead that I need to find out. That's why I like to watch anime sometimes. That's why when I do finally watch anime, you won't see me playing games or nothing. I'll be sitting there just admiring the show, I guess. You can see.
Yeah.
I'll be there just like watching it, binging it, and like go through a whole arc maybe. Or maybe I'll spend the next 2 days doing that. But I cannot. Like, but after I reach a certain point, I wouldn't say I burn out on it, but I'm just like, okay, I've reached a certain point. I need to stop, and I'll come back to it.
Yeah.
I haven't been watching too much anime lately because I've been playing games more often than not. Right.
Question. Since we did talk about Glepnor and fan service, do you think fan service hurts an anime or adds to it?
Ooh. It can actually be a bit of both, actually. Let's put it like this, because I feel like people who watch anime, like, they have a certain genre they like watching, and not everybody likes fan service, even no matter what genre you watch. Like, you can enjoy the hell out of, like, an adventure genre or, like, a fighting genre, but if, you know, I feel like someone would react different because, like, you know, let's say you're watching a fight manga, or, like, a fight anime, right?
Mm.
And then you don't know what you're getting into, right? It's your first time watching an episode. The very, very first episode, you're fighting, like, you know, this bitch gets blasted with, like, a Kamehameha or something, right? Like, some random enemy or something. And then her clothes strip off, and you see like her bare tits or something. And
yeah.
I feel like to some people that'd be appealing, but to some people that'd like turn it off right then and there, and not even bother with the rest of the anime because they don't like that.
Yeah.
Regardless of what they hear, like, yo, this is really good. It gets better. Some people can't really look past the fan service, but some people they really like that. They like the sexual appeal of the characters, whether it be male or female characters, because they don't just fan service the female characters. You know, sometimes they have characters like in One Piece. I have my man Zoro jacked, like. Man got a whole six pack. His back muscles poking out his back. He's a rip, dude. And some females really like that, you know. And some guys might like that too, but I don't. That's their preference, you know. But, you know, like I said, it just really depends on the person.
Cause yeah.
It'll either help or it'll hurt because that'll make people want to keep watching. Cause they'll be like, oh yeah, you know, oh man, they got titties first episode, bro. Keep me watching. What's up? I'm trying to see more titties. What's up? The other character in the back, yeah, she looking kind of fine too. I can't wait till she fights and gets fucking stripped naked.
Yeah, I think it.
Some people.
For me, I think it depends on the anime. Yeah, I think for me it depends on the anime. Like, say if I'm watching like Naruto or like something serious, and they do like random girls stripping and shit, then I'm gonna feel like for example, I Glepnor. I'm watching the first couple episodes. Like, I told my wife I'm not gonna watch this. It seems stupid. The fan service was just like, so this girl was supposed to commit suicide, but the bear dude found her. Like in her house with a house burning. Okay, so she burnt her house down to kill herself. However, she had like her shirt off and her bra showing and shit. Like, who kills himself like that? But kills those people. But if I'm watching like High School DxD, you know, I'm okay. Like, I understand what the anime is about. Like, yes, this guy does a move and he could talk to your boobs and find out what move you're gonna do. It's funny to me. But I think it's just about like what, okay. Yeah, the type of anime it is. I don't mind fan service, but I think I'd rather it done right.
Okay. Oh, no, I kind of see what you mean.
You like High School DxD? You watched it?
Yeah, I haven't watched the newest season because the animation change threw me a little off. So, but I mean, I watched it a long time ago.
Yeah, it was weird. It's coming out with a couple new seasons. Yeah.
Yeah, I'll probably check it out once more comes out so I can just binge watch it in one sitting.
Favorite female in High School DxD?
Ha, see, I love my president.
Gasper.
Bro. I love my President Riaz, bro. My color red is one of my favorite colors.
Yeah.
Right? But
so I love Akino.
Black. So is black. That's what I was about to go. Akino and Riaz are like my two favorite ones, but I don't know. Something about Akino just drives me a little crazy. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I thought you liked that little kitty cat girl. She's a freaky one, you know? For a second.
Fuck no, dude. One of my friends really likes her, bro, and I'm just like, what's wrong with you?
I think they like originally like played her off as a loli, and then they just said, you know what, we're just gonna make her a cat girl, because I don't know. It was weird. I didn't like her because she was like super lolly-ish.
I mean, her name was always like Koneko, and it's like Neko in the name, cat. Mm. So, kind of saw it.
Are you watching Sour God?
I am not, actually. I'm waiting for God of High School. That's what I'm waiting for. People are like, Tower of God's really good, because I've actually been reading that Tower of, God of High School on the Webtoons app.
Yeah.
I have that app. And I don't know if you started watching it, or it's not out yet, but reading it, but it's really, really good. And I'll explain a little bit about it, but basically, the main character's name is Jin or whatever, Mori Jin, that's what his name is. And so these people one day start showing up at school, recruiting people that are strong at fighting. Then they're having them all like fight each other in a ring. At least this is how it starts, right? They're trying to find the strongest ones. First, they haven't explained why they're looking for them, but they're just trying to find the strongest people they can find and recruit them. And the way they're appealing to this is if you win the tournament, they can grant you any wish that you want. Some people have selfish reasons why they're fighting. Other people have reasons behind their fight. That's why every fight can sometimes be like, I don't want this guy to lose because, you know, his grandpa's lying in the hospital and I really want him to win.
Yeah.
But this guy has his little sister whose surgery he needs to pay for, you know, and I want him to win. But, I mean, necessarily, none of those things are... One of those is a true one. The other one I made up, but, you know, you can see, like, why each one of them would want to win. Mm. That's what's really appealing to me. And then the fights are really, like, at least when they were drawn on that, they were drawn really good. So, I mean, I'm just waiting for it. And the characters are really interesting. Some people fight with Taekwondo.
Yeah.
And you're actually allowed to use weapons. So people who, like, practice Kendo can bring their katanas. And they have, like, this nanotechnology where you get injured, like, you break a leg. The thing will, like,
heal you up.
Instantly almost repair you. Yeah. So,
I don't have really don't have them. Time to read manga or like webs. I work a lot, and if not, I'm working on stream stuff or like something else. But looking forward to that. I hear a lot of good things. Right now, I'm watching Sour God, and it's really good. Following that simp Bam, I like it, dude.
Damn.
He's a simp. Hold on.
What? Well, alright, I'll have to check it out, because my brother tells me about it. He's like, yo, I've been reading Tower of God.
So you never read it, right?
No, I've never read it. My brother's been reading it. He's been reading it for a long time, so he's just like, the anime's coming out. He's hyped for it. He said, I'm going to hate that bitch named Juliet, or whatever her name is.
I don't think like I said, I don't read the webtoons, but Juliet, now, has not been announced, but it's about this kid named Bam.
No, it's not. No, what's the female, main female's name?
Rachel.
I remember. Yeah, that's what he said. He said, you're going to hate Rachel.
I already hate her, dude. Yeah. I already fucking hate her. The dude is going through so much just to see her. Like, I guess he was like a blank slate, and she took him in and taught him things of like how to talk and about life and shit like that. And then she goes, you know what? I'm going to leave for the tower, because I think same thing with God of High School. Whoever wins the tournament, or whoever climbs the tower gets their wish granted. She wants to see stars. Oh. So she left him. Just to see stars. Bam is like, no, I love you. I want to be near you. And he goes to the tower and he's going through all these shits just to see her. They're on the same fucking floor. And she's like, no, I'm not Rachel. Like, yeah, stay away from me and shit like that. It's like, it's I don't know. I'm pretty sure there's reasons behind it that they haven't explained. Oh! Hold on real quick. There you go. You hear me?
Yeah, I hear you. You look cut off for a second.
I'm pretty sure there's reasons that they haven't explained, but as of now, I don't like Rachel. Don't like her.
My brother is like, you're gonna hate her, bro. You're gonna hate her so much. And I'm like, okay, I haven't watched it yet.
But
which, by the way, when you watch the Shield Hero, there's a female character they introduce in that show that you're gonna hate. And when I say hate, you're gonna hate her. Like, I really mean you're gonna hate her. That's why I think you should watch it. Like watch the first three episodes they introduce her by then, and then you'll understand what I'm talking about when you get to that point. Because everyone fucking hates that character, man. And I understand why. Like, she's such a bitch. But I don't know how much of a bitch Rachel is, but this character is, like, top-tier bitch. Like people hate her.
She's not a bitch to people. She's just like, oh, don't tell Bam that I'm Rachel. And then she just, like, doesn't even eat with everybody. Like, they have, like, a cafeteria because they're all on the same floor. And she just hides in her room and eats apples. That's it. She doesn't, like, talk to nobody. But it's like, I don't know, but the anime is good, man. It's very Hunter x Hunter-ish. Like, if you loved Hunter x Hunter, it's giving off Hunter x Hunter vibes.
I did like Hunter x Hunter.
Hunter x Hunter was amazing.
I sit there and I finished it. But last time I cried that hard at an anime, I don't even remember, but it was Hunter x Hunter for sure.
Which part did he cry at?
The part with the king, with Mirum and what's
her name? Oh, the girl, dude.
The blind chick.
Yeah.
That shit hit me so hard. He just wanted her back to play Shield Hero.
Mm-hmm.
And that hit me so hard. They're like, are you still there? And she was like, yeah.
Oh, and they kept repeating that and shit like that until it faded out. Yeah.
And then that shit hurt me so hard. Like, I sat there bawling my eyes out. That's probably the first, not even the first time. There's been other times, but that was probably the last time I remember crying that hard was at that scene right there, like at an anime. And that hit me so hard. I don't know why, but it really did. I was like, fuck, man.
I cried when Jiraiya died. That
was really sad too.
Yeah, that and there was a anime that came out late last year called Somali and the Forest Spirit. That made me cry. It's as a father, that shit. It's about this like golem who's supposed to like protect nature, protect the forest and stuff like that. And he finds like a baby human. So the whole concept is a golem only has a set time to live before he dies, and then another golem takes his place. So he's trying to find like a human civilization to drop off the kid at. However, time is running out and humans are nearly extinct in that world. Without talking about it, but that shit does choke you up.
Damn, it sounds like my kind of show.
It's fun. It's a good anime. It's very cutesy with the that. I think they did it right because it was like another anime with like a father daughter thing. What the freak was it called? But it's like this adventurer finds like a demon child, and it's like there's a lot of magic involved, but it's like he's very annoying. He's like, oh, I love you, and he's like, he's very obsessive over his daughter. Like it's very, I don't know how to explain it. It's just not good. It just wasn't good. I forgot the name of it. That's how bad it was. And I didn't watch it again.
The first anime I sat through and like watched entirely was actually like Bleach. Bleach was the very first anime I watched like that. And, I can't even say I watched it in its entirety because I caught up with the anime at the time.
Yeah.
And I couldn't watch like the very newest. Like the whole like Lost Agent arc is another one I never finished. It got animated and I never finished it. But I know what happens because someone like spoiled the manga for me and stuff. And yeah, so that's the one I very like watched in its entirety. And then I went back to Naruto and finished that up. And then my anime like watching got slowly went from there. Like I watched separate animes from time to time, played games mostly. Like probably spent the more time playing games than I would watch anime, but I probably have a balance of both of those somewhere.
Yeah, I think I started out with Pokemon too. I think that was my earliest, but I at that time I didn't know it was an anime. I had no idea what anime was. Anime. Yeah. And then when I made the conscious decision to like, all right, let me just watch an anime, I think mine was Death Note. Then I went to One Punch Man. Then I ended up just trying to catch up to like Naruto and everything else, and then just the floodgates were open.
You said your favorite anime was Naruto, right?
Favorite anime is Naruto.
Why?
It's
simply a nostalgia thing, or?
No, it's just amazing. The story is dope. I don't know. I feel like I relate so much to all the characters in there. It's not just one character. I see myself related to Naruto. Like, he's fearless. Doesn't matter if he fucks up. He's just going to keep going straight, right? Rock Lee is another one of my favorites. I can relate to him because he's like, yeah, he can't do any jutsus, but...
Yeah, but he's trying his hardest.
Yeah, and then Gaara, I was lonely as a kid. So I can also relate to Gaara. I think I can relate to anybody except for like Sakura and Sasuke. Cause I would never abandon my friends for power or shit like that. I don't know.
Did you murder people as a kid or something? What's going on? You said Gaara? Hold on. Naruto was lonely too, you know? He didn't murder them.
No, but Gaara, I don't know. It's a different story from Gaara. Like, he became like...
Gaara's
dope.
Murdered everyone simply because he couldn't even sleep because the monster inside of him would take over.
Oh yeah. Yeah, but you can't blame him. Yeah. You can't blame the tailed beast, like, warped him.
Yep, I don't. Not even that. You remember, like, his own dad tried to kill him.
Mm-hmm.
The people he loved tried to kill him.
He had to tattoo love on his fucking forehead. Gaara's one of my favorites. And they became Kazekage, and then fucking General of the United Allied Shinobi Forces. That's why, like, in the fight scenes. Like, one of my favorite fight scenes this day is Obito versus Kakashi. When they go back with the flashbacks and them as kids.
So, yeah, that was so emotional, but also really good. I was just like, fuck, man.
Mm-hmm.
And they show them, like, right at the end, like, him picking them up after the spar as kids. But then it goes back to them in the current time. Like you know, Kakashi's running at him with a Chidori, and this man got a kunai in his hand. I'm like, oh, fuck, man.
Yeah,
that was so good. That's one of my favorite fights.
Just thinking about that, I fucking got goosebumps. I love that fight.
Yeah, bro, that fight is amazing.
What is your favorite anime now? Like, what are you watching now that's got you hooked?
Got me hooked? I can't say anything really got me hooked. I go back and forth between animes, but there's one anime that I've really been wanting to get into. It's Code Geass, because I heard it's really good. It's like a mech anime.
Yeah.
I don't know too much about it, but the character was really cool. He has like this eye that he uses to manipulate people, I think. So kind of like Shisui in a
film.
And I really want to watch it. Everyone tells me it's one of the best anime ever, and it's really good, and I should watch it. And I've been thinking about it. I'm like, bro, I haven't watched a good mech anime in a while, and I want to watch it. But anime that's got me hooked right now, I can't really say an anime's got me hooked, because I haven't really been watching anime. Like I said... I read anime or like watch or like manga and watch anime up to a certain point and I take a break from it.
Yeah.
But the animes that I have not finished that I'm still watching, I haven't finished the second part of City Hunter. I haven't finished the second part of what is that anime called? Fuck. I can think of the characters but I can't think of the name. You probably won't know it either. Never mind that.
No.
One Piece, but I still have the good point of One Piece. And people like to shit talk One Piece for being so long and whatever, but and I used to be one of those people, like, man, fuck One Piece. But but I once I started watching it, I was just like, well, this is actually really, really good. And like,
I've heard it's really good. I think that's the reason I don't want to really start it, because it's like so long, and it's like I know I'm going to get hooked on it. And then, like, so once I get hooked on something, everything else just goes in the back burner. Like, I forgot I had a daughter. You know, I gotta finish watching this. I'm sorry, Ellie, but let me finish these 900 something episodes, and then I'll feed you. You know,
that's why I think like it's an acceptable thing to like take breaks, because that's how I was too. Like, I forget I have responsibilities, but I'm watching anime. But that's why I like to take breaks. Like after like let's say you know you just watch Naruto, the pain fight just finished. A good stopping point, you know, there's nothing too much on your mind.
Mm-hmm.
There's stuff you know that's coming next, like you know Sasuke's still out there, you know. You want to see what's going to happen to the Hidden Leaf or whatever. How are they going to rebuild it? Naruto's a hero now, whatever the fuck. But, like, I think taking breaks is pretty good. So it's just so you can maintain your life and you know, what you got to do.
Yeah.
So that's why I do that.
Break Day is good. You got to see, like, the best entrance. Like, Sakura screaming, Naruto! And then he just comes in with fucking frogs and shit, all saged up.
And the music, you know what I'm talking about?
Mm-hmm.
Like, beat that was, like, and then... And then it goes like doom, 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 and it zooms out. He's sitting on a frog, sitting in another frog that's surrounded by other frogs. And you're like, yo!
Yo, you know some shit's about to go down.
Yeah. And then they like turn around to see him, I think. I think it was before that or after that.
Yeah.
And then you just see him. It's wearing the cloak, and then you look at his eyes, and he has the Sage Mode ID. You're like, oh shit! I remember that. Yeah, good feeling. One of my favorite moments in the show happened during that pain fight too.
Which one?
The Hinata moment. I love that moment. So much. I don't know why. I just do. She admitted his feelings to him or whatever, and then she ran up and tried to fight that man, knowing she wasn't gonna win. And then she got like picked up all the way into the sky, slammed into the floor. Before that she was like getting pushed back and shit. And like even when she couldn't like had this, she didn't have no more strength to even pull the rod out of his hand. She crawled over to him, tried to pull it out, and this man Pain said, "Bitch," lifted her up into the sky and slammed her down. And then Naruto found the strength to get out of that fucking like rods. That was so sad. I really thought she died.
She should have fucking just brought Konohamaru there and Rasengan him.
I think he got a lucky Rasengan on one of those pains.
Yeah.
But that was it. He didn't do shit.
The way he learned the Rasengan was hilarious, though.
I don't remember how he learned it.
Basically, Naruto was trying to, like, teach him. He was like, "I'm going to teach you something new." And Konohamaru took it as, "You're going to teach me a new type of, like, sexy jutsu." And he's like, no, it's not that. You got to do this. But he was like showing how to do the Rasengan. But instead of using words, he was using sounds. So he's like, vroom, vroom, and this like that. So he needed inspiration from like sexy females. So he took like, what's that dude with glasses? He had like a big like hentai collection. And he was looking at the girls in bathing suits there. And he was like, basically it was a fun little like arc.
Wasn't his name like Ibisu? Wasn't his name Ibisu. Like he had to do with the glasses?
Yeah.
And like the black do-rag or whatever?
Mm-hmm. The one that was guarding.
Like the sensei? Yeah. I know who you're talking about. Yeah. All right. So you want to know what my favorite anime is? You want to take a guess? You didn't ask me, so. You want to take a guess?
I'm going to say.
It should be a no-brainer.
It should be a no-brainer? Then I'm going to say Hitman Reborn. Because of your name.
You're fucking right! But yeah, because you want to know why?
I never watched the anime because the dude has fire in his hair, in his hand, and there's like a little midget that follows him.
Yeah, a baby, but he's a hitman baby. He's a fucking mafia boss. Like, not a mafia boss, but he's a member of the mafia.
You told me everybody knows he got reincarnated into a baby or something like that. He was born.
No, he's cursed.
Okay.
But they don't explain that until later on. But let me explain a little bit as to why I really like this character and why people should give his anime a shot. The anime I would recommend to you as well, without trying to spoil anything. But so there's this kid named Suna, right? Tsunayoshi. Sawada Tsunayoshi.
It's a bad name.
That name's badass. Sawada Tsunayoshi.
Yeah, that name's better than Suna X.
Okay. There's a reason why it's X, because it's number 10. Okay. That's what it stands for, the number 10.
Right, but anyway. Sorry.
So he's a loser. Like, it just starts off as a normal kid in Japan, but he's bad at everything. He's short. He's like 5'1 or something.
Like you. Okay.
Okay. All right. I was going to add on to that, but hold on. And he's really bad at everything. Like, he's bad at like sports. He's bad at school. He sleeps in class. He's late to class. He's so bad at everything. Like, sports, swimming, everything that you do in Japan. Like, you have volleyball teams and stuff. He's just bad at everything, right? And so they then earn him the name No Good Suna, and it follows him around. Everybody's like, "Yo, it's No Good Suna." But one day, Reborn gets sent on a mission to Japan. Reborn is that hitman baby with the outfit, with the tuxedo and shit. And his mission is to train the next candidate for the Vongola family. And they pick the next number 10, right? The 10th Vongola candidate, which is why the X is resembled. A number 10. Mm. That's why he's Vongola X. That's what they call him. He's next in line to become, the next Vongola boss. But he refuses. He doesn't want to. But Reborn doesn't give up. He was like, job is to make sure you're
he
the
just
picked
somebody
Vongola
random?
Candidate.
Is he like the son of somebody?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, he has mafia like bloodline or bloodline heritage or whatever. But they picked him to be the next leader. But because he's been picked as the next leader, he doesn't want the responsibility. But before that, he was a loser, right? He had no friends, nothing. Mm. He was just a lonely kid who was bad at everything. He always runs away from his problem. He's a coward. He's bad. He's horrible, right? Mm. And it kind of reminds me of myself, in
definitely,
a sense.
Definitely, definitely.
So that's
I see
why
it.
I really... Okay, all right. But that's why I like the character so much. I relate to him. And then... he meets somebody who changes his life in a sense, like because he meets Reborn, he finally has the guts to talk to his crush, because he Reborn does something without really trying to spoil too much. Like, there's this thing called the Dying Will Bullet. He uses that with his gun. And so he shoots you in the head with it. And if you have no regrets, right, like, as the bullet's hitting you, you'll die. But the thing with Suna is he always has a regret, you know? So if you have a regret, you come back with the fire in your head. And for some reason, it makes you, like rip off all your clothes except your underwear. So what he does, he ends up running the school, challenges a dude to a kendo match, talks to his crush, tells him he likes her, and then he goes back to normal, and he's naked in front of all these people. Like, what the fuck is going on? But because of that, because of Reborn, he ends up meeting friends and people, and he finally, like, you know, becomes not a boss. Throughout the whole series, he's denying being a boss. He doesn't want to be a boss. But because he's next in line to become a boss, there's no way he can, like, really deny it. People want him to become the next boss because he's the next candidate. But because of that, there's people that want to go and kill him because he's the next Mongola boss candidate. People want, you know, to, like, other rival boss, like, mafias want to go and kill him. They want to go and some other people want to take over his body through other means and stuff. And some people, like, they want to do shit to kill him or, like, to take his power. But he, the whole time, he just refusing the fact that he wants to be a Mongola boss. So it's just hilarious because throughout the whole show, people do, like, things that don't make any sense to, like, a normal person. I guess, like, for the viewer, I guess you consider Suna, like, a normal person because he's a coward. And he's like, so people casually talk about, like, well, we just gotta go kill the guy. And Suna's sitting there like, what the fuck is wrong with you guys? What do you mean you gotta go kill him? Everybody's just, and this, like, and the whole point is that he gets friends and they end up becoming, like, his guardian. He gets his right-hand man, someone else who becomes part of his family.
Yeah.
And they end up, like, he ends up becoming, like, friends. Because of Reborn, he meets friends and people where he can rely on. And he ends up talking to his crush, meets another girl, like, he talks to people, and he's interacting with them just fine. But because he's Mongola boss candidate, the next one, his friends often, like, get into fights and stuff and then trouble. And I think the show is just really good. And I can relate a lot to the character. And they introduce the Mongola rings and stuff. And it's not, it starts off as, like, a slice of life. Like, the first 20 episodes are introducing, like, all the characters, their backstories and stuff. Like, every episode you'll have, like, a new character or something being introduced. And then, like, once episode 20 starting, like,
it gets into it.
It gets into the series. Like, there's some, the very first villain appears. Like, they're trying to kill Suna and shit. Like, some people show up, try to kill him. And his friend's, like, dedicated. He's, like, a dedicated mafia member. He's like, I'm gonna be your right-hand man. Like, I'll die for you, boss. And, like, Suna was about to get killed. He jumps in front of him, almost dies. Like, stuff like that. And at one point, Suna, like, learns, he's like, he can't be a bitch no more. He's actually really strong, but he's such a bitch. And it's, like, the funniest thing ever. But I don't know. The show's a great watch. It's your common, typical shonen, but where, like, all the characters are really unique, and you'll learn to love the characters so much. Like, it's a slice of life that goes into battle manga and then goes back to being a slice of life into another battle manga. It's balanced battle scenes and slice of life with, like, comedy, small amounts of romance here and there. But the whole show is kind of like gag and battle.
Okay.
And slice of life. And that's what makes it so good. I love it.
I'll try to sit down and watch it.
I think you might get hooked if you watch it the first
time. How long is it?
100-something episodes.
Damn.
That's how much anime.
I mean, it's not that long.
It's not a lot.
No. I've watched City Hunter. I mean, not City Hunter. Hunter Hunter, which is like 100 and...
Around the same, yeah.
Yeah, it's around the same thing. Alright, so real quick before we wrap it up. Bleach is going to be one of the... They announced the 5 characters for Season 2 of Jump Force.
Yep.
Who do you think is going to be Bleach? Like, from Bleach. I'm hoping Kenpachi.
So, because they've had 2 characters in the files that they scrapped from Bleach since launch, they had Byakuya and Kenpachi in the files. Like, their files are there. You can find them. They've been scrapped since launch. So they could be added in, but we don't know yet. Because, like I said, they might want to promote the manga and the anime coming back.
Mm-hmm.
So they could give us the villain from the Thousand Year Blood War, which is your watch. Nell comes back in the manga. So they could give us Nell if they wanted to.
That would be amazing.
One of those 4 characters would be the characters I would like to see. The Mad, if they wanted to add them. Someone said Orihime, which I love Orihime. I really do.
I don't see her as a fighter.
Yeah, I don't see her. I couldn't see her in Jump Force, really.
No.
But, you know, you could see, like, Byakuya, Kenpachi, your watch, who's, like, one of the villains in the manga, and Nell would definitely be the one. I had more female reps. Nell would be a good...
Yes.
Yeah. We already know what she could do. And people would love to see Nell. Like, you know,
I love Nell, too. Who do you think is coming from Hunter x Hunter?
For Hunter x Hunter, this is so weird because like people want Leorio, and I wouldn't mind him.
Why?
He didn't do too much. He didn't do
All he did was just punch through like a desk and punch Ging's dad. Yeah.
Yeah, but like he'd be cool because then you'd have the whole like trio, like the squad, you know, like Leorio, Krabappel, Gon.
But they only teamed up like one time. There wasn't even a set team. Like mainly it was just Gon and Killua, and then they went on adventures and shit like that. But
yeah, yeah. And like I would like Leorio, but I don't want him.
No, I think it would be a waste. I like Leorio, yeah, but no, I think it would be a waste.
Yeah, no, I do. But here's the thing, like they could add him, but I would. The same thing that they did with Bisky is like people are like, why are you so mad they added Bisky, bro? I'm like, I don't hate Bisky. I like the character. No, yeah. I think Bisky's cool. But why would you pick Bisky or Leorio over Melrum, Netero, Lumi, Kite? Like, what? Who thought Bisky was the choice?
And the thing about, so with the whole like, all right, so they have fucking Yugi and Kaiba with the whole draw thing, right? Kite would be amazing because like it's whatever it.
Yes. A similar mechanic.
My god, dude. Yeah.
If they do give us that Kite, but like I said, because the old Gon has now is a different old. It's like it happened after the Kite thing.
Mm-hmm.
So I mean, if they wanted to give us that Kite, that'd be cool. But do I want to see? Preferably Milram. I want to see Milram.
Milram would be dope.
King flying around with his wings.
I can see him up against Cell and shit.
Cell. Mm. Yes. I've been asking for Milram for a long time. So I really hope we get Milram. Or Netero would be pretty cool too.
Netero would be dope. People around with the arms and shit. That would be a great ass ult.
Yes. If they want to add Killua's brother, he'd be kind of cool. Illumi, I'm
Chrono, Crollo.
If they want to add Crollo, he'd be kind of cool. Maybe steal the person's ability somehow. Maybe find a way to incorporate that. That'd be badass.
Mm.
And like, I guess if they wanted to add, who else? I guess they could add Kite or one of the Phantom Troop members. But
that would be
Melrum, Crollo,
Netero,
Kite are like the ones I'm looking. Yeah, Netero, Melrum, Crollo, Kite are like the ones I'm looking at. Illumi,
not really Illumi.
So those are the ones I'm looking at for the Hunter x Hunter like reps. But like I said, I really hope they don't shaft us and give us Leorio. Leorio is cool, but I would like I said, the same thing with Bisky is I don't know why you would want Bisky or Leorio over those monstrous, really badass characters that would look amazing in the game. That's why when people like seem to have this misconception that I hate Bisky, I'm like, I don't hate Bisky, I just don't want her in the game.
They should have been someone better.
Other characters. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. And you know why I think they added Bisky? It's because these horny ass motherfuckers on launch, when the beta's coming out, we're like, yo, can we get more female reps?
I think they do need more females, but titties.
They do, but because of that, we ended up getting Bisky.
Nah.
Yeah, shut your asses up. Yeah, shut
your asses up. Okay. I think they could, I don't know, man. If they want to add the female character from, like, Bleach, I would say no. Not Orihime.
No.
She doesn't fight.
Well, Orihime is cool, but she doesn't fight. Yeah, no, I love Orihime. I trust you. I'm behind you on that, 100%.
What's she gonna do, like, shield? I mean, she does have the thing where, like, she has the thing.
Guys that she has little things. I know what you're talking about, little airplane dude.
Yeah, it's like a bug. Yeah, but she has to have the intent to kill in order for that to even work, or else it's just gonna bounce off and you're gonna end up killing that little fly thing that comes out your hair.
Yeah, I think if they did add her, it'd be cool because we'd have another healer besides Karapika, but I don't want her in the game.
Mm.
I want Byakuya. That's who I want. Part of the Byakuya Kenpachi, I want Byakuya. I love Byakuya. He's walking around with like flower petals. Imagine, some dude just like.
Yo, imagine if they add. Imagine if they add that guy from that princess arc where he has like the sword and then like the flowers come around and just stick to you and shit and it covers your screen.
Fuck no. Bro, that's so stupid. Don't say that. Manda is so dumb, they might do something.
Yo, I'm gonna fucking tweet at Bandai Namco and ask for that character specifically.
No. But people really want Lukiora, but I don't see it happening because we're in a whole other arc. And they're like, no, but, you know, these characters are, the Bisky's being added to the arc.
Mm.
You know, that's the Chimera and arc, Gon and Killua. And I'm just like, okay, but that's like one arc apart. Like,
really,
after the arc ended with Bisky, they got the little card and teleported to Kite. And that's when the Ant arc started, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So. But Ulquiorra's been, like, long dead. Like, there's no way they'll bring back Ulquiorra over, like, fucking, you know, like, your watch. I'm pretty sure.
I'm praying for Kenpachi. That's who I want.
Kenpachi's cool. I don't mind Kenpachi, but I love Byakuya. I love Byakuya. Mm. He's been one of my favorite characters ever since I saw him. And, like, You know how scary it would be? Some dude says Sanbon Zagura Kageyoshi, turns his katana around, drops it out of his hand, and it goes straight into the ground. And all you see is a bunch of flower petals everywhere.
Oh my god, cinematically that would look so dope.
Beautiful. I would love to see that. That'd be so scary over some buff ass dude with like a sword, you know, and like a giant axe, because he does get a giant axe. From what I seen, I don't know if that's accurate. I think that might be fan of.
Probably Mango.
But,
or,
yeah. But yeah, but I would love Byakuya or Kenpachi or Yawash or Nell, preferably. I hope we don't get someone random. I like Orihime, but I can't say I don't want
him. Oh man.
Same thing for like Leorio Bisky. I would not.
They're gonna add Leorio and Orihime as the next DLC. It's gonna be
stop
fun.
Stop saying that, bro.
It's gonna be fun. Either that or the flower guy from the Princess Arc.
And,
I'm praying for that guy.
And then there's another. I don't know. Have you seen Yu Yu Hakusho? They have a Yu Yu Hakusho.
No, I haven't. I haven't seen it, but I know people want Hiei or EA or something like that.
Hiei or Kurama. People are all like.
Kurama's already in there.
Hiei. Not that Kurama.
Okay.
Shut up. Kurama is this beautiful man. Long red hair, uses roses as whips, and roses are my favorite kind of flower. I don't know if you know that, but yeah.
And now I know.
Transform into a fox too, like a silver fox.
Mm.
So they can have a transformation for him. I would love him over Hiei, but the popularity for Hiei is just so crazy. He comes out number one on every single popularity. Mm. That's how crazy like how people much love Hiei. So I couldn't see them passing up on Hiei again. And so I think it's Hiei. There's no way it could not be Hiei. And then there's what else? Is JoJo. They have JoJo Bizarre Adventure. I don't know if you've seen JoJo's, but
I can't get it. Not for me.
Okay, I feel you. I'm gonna try to watch it at some point, but I can see why you wouldn't want to watch it. But the amount of people that were dick sucking Bandai for Hiei and Giorno, I could not see them not adding Giorno.
Yeah.
But some people are saying it might be the next
to promote the next from the
next season. Yeah, I think it's like season 6 of the.
There's some girl, season. Right?
There's a female named Jolene. Yeah. So I could see them doing that as well, but and there would be a female rep, so it wouldn't be too bad. But they fumble the bag so hard if it's not Giorno, because so many people want Giorno. All the piano memes, people love Giorno. Like I don't even watch JoJo, and I can tell you exactly how many people like how like big Giorno is. People love Giorno, and you would have like JoJo. Jotaro, Giorno, and you know Dio in a team, so that'd be kind of badass, you know. So I could see them adding Giorno, and then so I guess you know we already have Todoroki confirmed coming out, which I am very upset about.
Why Todoroki? I think cinematically he would look dope. Who you wanted? Like
okay. No.
Overhaul.
That's not why. And people got to get mad at me for this, but I do not want another My Hero Academia character. I think it was kind of pointless to add another one. Because they had two characters last season, and those two characters were like All Might and Bakugo, which are cool. Those are really nice characters, right?
Mm.
But why would you give us another one? And around the same time, they had the My Hero game, My Hero 1 Justice 2 coming out. And my thing is, like, no one's going to want to, like, hop back on Jump Force. Oh, Todoroki's on Jump Force? No way! They're probably already playing My Hero 1 Justice.
Mm.
As popular as the character is, a lot of people, and I can see why people don't like Jump Force. No one's gonna be like, oh, let me hop off of my Hero 1 Justice 2, where I love and play Todoroki, to go on a Jump Force and play Todoroki.
Yeah.
I don't see why people want to do that. But someone made a point. It's like, well, and you can jump in 1 Justice 2, you can't play as, you know, Ryo, Todoroki, and Toguro, you know?
Yeah.
And I can see that, but still. Like, and I get they're doing it for a marketing idea, but they had a My Hero game strictly for My Hero fan. Any My Hero fan that loves Todoroki,
they should have just stayed on that. Yeah,
they'll just stay on 1 Justice 2. I don't think they would hop up on 1 Justice 2 to hop on Jump Force, because arguably, I think the one's OJ 2 is more annoying to play than Jump Force.
Mm.
Some people, but, you know.
No, I played OJ 1 and I loved it. I played Uraka and Todoroki. Those are my two people that I switched back and forth from.
All right, we'll see. Like, I just don't think anyone would want to go from OJ 2 to Jump Force. I don't think so. I think it was a waste of a slot. You know what anime would have deserved that slot, though?
What?
Black Clover. And I think a lot of people would agree.
Because that has one.
Why
yeah.
Do we only have one.
One Black Clover.
It's only Asta. And Black Clover's been doing really good lately. It's doing really good. And why would you not have, like, you have Vegeta, Goku, Sasuke, Naruto. You have, Gon, Killua. Hiei is coming, I'm guessing. So it'd be Hiei, Yusuke.
Yeah.
And you know, you have like the hero and the anti-hero, like, you know, like the two rivals. And we have what? Deku or
Deku, Bakugo, Todoroki.
So why wouldn't we have Asta's like rival? His rival is Yuno, and that's one of the one of the most popular characters in Black Clover. I don't know why we didn't get another Black Clover rep when Black Clover's been doing good. And they didn't get a single character last season. My Hero got two. They're getting another one. And we didn't get we don't have anything for Black Clover. Like, Black Clover's not getting any love, and it's doing really good. Like, I don't know why they didn't give us Yuno. Yuno would be like Asta's rival. And I'm liking Black Clover. I haven't watched too much of it, and I love all the openings. That's the reason I'm watching it. And I think Asta's like an annoying character sometimes, but I'm starting to grow. Like, he's starting to grow on me. All the yelling and stuff is growing on me. I don't see why we couldn't get his rival. Why did we have to get Todoroki? We have a 3-man team of My Hero characters. Why couldn't we? We should have just left it at that. That's why I'm upset about it. Some people are like, wow, but you know, they're adding another Bleach character. They got two last season. And my defense to that is that you see all the big series. What are the big series in Jump Force right now?
Right now, with the way they promote it, which got a lot of people twisted about the big three, is Naruto, Dragon Ball, and One Piece.
Yeah, those are like the big three. And how many characters those series have? I can answer for you.
Oh my god. Naruto, I think, has like five or six.
Six.
Well, five. Boruto has his own thing, but...
Yeah, but they're counted as Naruto.
Yeah.
They have six?
Dragon Ball has what?
Without the DLC. Base roster. Without DLC. Nope, it has six as well. So, let me just answer this for you.
And One Piece.
Dragon Ball, One Piece, and Naruto are like some of the big three anime, I guess you could say. They have six representatives each, excluding the DLCs, like base roster, right? And base roster, Bleach has four representatives and two that got scrapped, which were Byakuya and Kenpachi. And with the DLC, they have Toshiro and they have Grimmjow. Yeah.
Grimmjow,
so
yeah.
Now they have six to match the big three. And then all the big three got anime too. They got Madara, they got Law, and what was it? Naruto? It was Madara, Law, and then Majin Buu. So they had another rep on top of that. So now the big three have seven characters, right? And base roster, Bleach only had four, has six now. And they're getting another one, so they have seven. I think it's fair, because Bleach used to be one of the big three.
Bleach is the big three.
Ended, it was one of the big three, yeah. I mean, the anime's ended now. It used to be one of the big three. It was Naruto, One Piece, and Bleach all the time. When Dragon Ball had ended, there was no Dragon Ball Z left. He was one of the big three. I found it. I'm glad they did. People are like, Bleach doesn't need another character. I'm like, bro, that's so disrespectful. I think it's very disrespectful for one of the former big three to only get four characters. And then people are complaining like, wow, you're not complaining about Bleach getting more characters. You know how nice
they want all these, they want all these like new things. Yeah.
Toshiro, Hitsugaya going into his adult form, which only got shown in the manga. Grimmjow coming back. He thought he was dead, I think. Most people thought he was dead, I guess. Grimmjow comes back, like, and they brought them into the game, and Grimmjow fights very uniquely. I think you've seen how he
I played him, yeah.
Very Grimmjow-like. Toshiro does his, like, quick swings and ice attacks. Very, very, like, you know, Rukia does her, like, beautiful, like, ice attacks across the map. Aizen teleports because he's using illusions. Ichigo's just Ichigo.
I hate Aizen in that game.
Renji's in there. Aizen is nasty. And Renji's in there. You know, they all play very uniquely. A lot of the other characters are kind of all the same. Like, why are we getting multiple Dragon Ball characters? They all kind of play the same, you know? They all have that rush attack, they have a beam attack, or like some kind of projectile. The big three is getting a fair amount of characters. Why isn't Bleach getting a fair amount of characters? Y'all seem to ignore that fact. And then another big series, you know, Black Clover isn't getting another rep. At least one more rep. That's so stupid. Considering the Black Clover game fumbled because it was bad.
Yeah.
I couldn't see them not adding a Black Clover rep to a game where you can play a Black Clover character. Yuna would look beautiful in that game. I've seen like what he can do a little bit of, like clips and stuff. He looks great. Like, he could really, like, I would really buy, like, the only character I'm disappointed in this whole pass for is Todoroki so far. Unless they give us, like, some really crappy character for the other series. Which then, I don't think they'll fumble on EA or Giorno.
Alright.
Or the Bleach character is probably not going to disappoint no matter what. Because it's a Bleach character. I can't see them disappointing with that character.
No.
The character is just horrible. Yeah. Even then, I'd still play it.
That's that flower guy.
Yeah.
Alright. Well, that's it for us, Suna. We're definitely going to get you on. No,
I had to talk about that Jump Force, though, man. I'm passionate.
You're very passionate about Jump Force. But we went over our time limit. We definitely got to get you in here for the next episode or even episode 3, man. I would love to have you back. All right, Suna, where can people find you?
If they want to find me, usually my Twitch is when I'm streaming. Twitch.tv, no good Suna X. It's the Goku Black with, like, a coffee mug, and he's like, what the fuck am I drinking type thing. That's what he looks like.
And you play.
Also, Goku Black's one of my favorite villains too, because he's a really badass villain. But, you know. And usually I'm playing either like. I want to say you can usually find me playing Jump Force, Fortnite, Overwatch. Those three are like my main.
Destiny too.
Right, but I'm also
Destiny
playing Persona 5. I guess Destiny. I have the game downloaded.
Yes.
But you know.
I will keep my word, and I will download Fortnite and play with you. I don't know. I play a couple games and then I'll delete it because I don't like it. But I did make a promise. I did say I was gonna download it and play with you.
Yep.
Nice.
And a little bit of Warzone when I play with y'all and Minecraft, I guess. And if they want to find me on like other social platforms, mm-hmm. like if they find me on Twitch, I don't know my exact Twitch or my Instagram username, but on Twitch, I think I have my IG link there.
Yeah.
And my Twitter where I post memes. I think my Twitter is also Nogatsune X. They can find me with that if they want to. Talk anime or something.
Don't worry, if you're watching this on YouTube, all his links will be in the description below, so make sure you definitely go check out Nogatsune. This won't be the last time you hear from him. I definitely want to get you on a lot more of these because this was hella fun. With that said, guys, I hope you enjoyed the first episode of Sakura, the most useless talk show about anime and gaming. Links to the Spotify will be in the description when that is up. You can find me at twitch.tv/DZisLive. That's D33ZISLIVE. All my socials are the same. DZisLive. All the links will be in the description below. Thank you for everybody for showing some love. And I'll see you guys on the next episode. Later, guys.